அஸ்மத் குருபியோ நமஹ, அஸ்மத் சர்வகுருபியோ நமஹ, அஸ்மத் பரமகுருபியோ நமஹ. ஆழ்வார் திருவடிகளே சரணம், எம்பெருமானார் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஸ்ரீரன்றுதொப்புல் திருவேங்கடமுடையான் திருவடிகளே சரணம். ஸ்ரீமான் வேங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிக கேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய வரியோமே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதாகிருதி. சுதர்ம ஞான வைராக்ய சாத்ய பக்தி ஏக கோச்சர நாராயண பரம் பிரம்ம கீதா சாஸ்திரே சமீரித. வி ஆர் கண்டினியூங் ஆன் தி டீகா. டுடே இஸ் தி 11th லெக்சர். இன் தி லாஸ்ட் செஷன் வி சா கிருஷ்ணா வாஸ் அர்ஜுனா வாஸ் ஆஸ்கிங் கிருஷ்ணா, கிருஷ்ணா யூ ஆர் எ உபாசியன், யூ டெல் தட் ஒன், ஹவு டு யூ திங்க் ஆஃப், ஹவு ஐ கேன் திங்க் ஆஃப் யூ, வாட் ஃபார்ம், வாட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் எ திங். So Krishna started advising, before you know about me, first the approach, how you have to do bhakti to me. So that is what he told and we saw in the last class. Maya sakta mana, mayi asakta mana, madhashraya. First, strong mind attached to me and then surrender to me, he said. And he is adding some more. Asam sayam samagram, asam sayam, that means free of any doubt. Samagram, completely. So, he says, oh Arjuna, listen, attach your mind completely to me, do the surrender to me, start practicing Bhakti Yoga, then you know me completely free of any doubt. Know me completely free of any doubt. We will not know Bhagavan completely. But for the Bhakti Yogam to get the phalan, for that what do you know? That's what he is saying. There is no way we cannot understand the Bhagavan. So, Maya Saktamana Partha Yogam Yunjat Madhashrayaha Asamsayam Samagrammam Yada Nyasyasi Tachrunu. Tachrunu, I am telling, why don't you listen? So, that is what the first sloka Krishna was telling. And here, you should do the contemplation about me with love. That contemplation should be all the time. And that contemplation is in such a way, contemplation is meditation. Think about him. I am different from everything. Vilakshanam. That is what the word Embarman are used. Vilakshanam. He is so superior compared to everything else. And for a nanosecond, if you cannot think of me, you will be like a fish out of the water. Thudikkanum. That is how we are doing. The desperation should kill you. That is the highest punishment you can get. Oru naal egadesi sapada mudiyalana, you feel so bad. I'm doing such a crime. One day you cannot do aradham, one day you cannot do sandhyavandam, one day you cannot. Because that is the biggest punishment you can give. Because his love is so much attached. And you have to come to that stage. So that is how you have to do bhakti. So he told first the process how you have to do. Okay. Now I am telling, what is the target? That is what next few slogans are going to be on the target. How do we think of Bhagavan? Divya Atma Swarupam. That is what we are going to look. First of all, I am Sarvajnan. There is nothing I don't know. Any place, any time, any form, everything is known to me simultaneously. I am going to instruct the knowledge about me, Arjuna, listen. Okay, and the knowledge, what we call jnanam, along with vijnanam. I'll tell you in a moment what is vijnanam. Without anything left out. Jnana, vijnana, I'm going to tell you, I'm not going to leave anything out, I'm going to tell. Once you get this one, you don't need anything else. Very beautifully Krishna says that one. All you have to know about me with this, you don't need anything else, that's all you need. Same thing with prabhati. What do you do? You have done prabhati, you got everything, there's nothing you have to do. Go and enjoy. Go and be a good person. Similarly here. Here, he has to think about Bhagavan continuously. There, you also have to think about Bhagavan. There, in our case, it is on and off. You can leave. Here, they have to be continuously. See, coming back here, jnana vijnana, you need that one. Jnana means what? Knowledge. Acquired through senses, mind, panja indriyam, panja jnana indriyam, karma indriyam, all of them, and intellect. all those things. Vijnana, that is a very difficult word. We have to interpret different meanings, okay? Vijnana means first one some people call wisdom. Knowledge comes from within. And arivilya apne thanavati paathiya, you have seen so many times. Oh, you cannot. Something you have to derive, that is called wisdom. Data, knowledge, and data, information, knowledge, and wisdom. That's where the expert system comes. In computer science, they teach. So the expert comes, uses the wisdom at the proper time. And the wisdom comes from the knowledge what they acquired. Knowledge comes from the data, raw data. So that is how it is. When you come here, vijnana means intellectual knowledge, something different. So how the intellectual knowledge will come in the spiritual way? Perumalta, experience. That is what it is. So when you do the experience, jnana. Yagadesi pattinda perumal pidikum. Perumal likes that one. That is jnana. Vijnana means, you know what? I've done 4 times that one Ekadesi. I never was angry. I'm so happy. I'm so happy to do that. That is, experimentally, you did that one, you enjoyed that one, you come up with the idea. That is the vijnana. So, Krishna says, bhakti is not telling all of them. You have to realize me. That is the vijnana. Once if you realize, then you are getting into that one. And that one, you have to keep on going for a long time. So, jnana, vijnana. That is one definition they are giving that one. Visa. This example, you know, obviously. Somebody says about jalebi. You have the knowledge of jalebi. But you cannot tell complete everything without tasting jalebi. I tasted jalebi here. I tasted jalebi there. I tasted jalebi there. You done. So I can tell you exactly what jalebi would be from different places and everything. Sir, in the divirasadla perumal here. In the divirasadla perumal. How do you do that? So you have to have some kind of a realization experience. That's what you need. Uddhava Gita also we said, Jnana Vijnana Samyukta Atma Bodha Sharirinam Atmanubhava Dushta Atma Nantaraya Vihanyase. That also. See, I want to bring both of them. Same Krishna telling here and there. No difference at all. But he's a different student here. This is a different student here. That's all it is. So we are all graduated. We go and sit down there. And just to pay respect to the teacher and how it was, okay? Going back to the school after the 12th grade, they are sitting there because they have to examine, they have to pass, okay? Here, jnana vijnanam, remember what we said in Uddhava Gita a long time back? Jnana means regular, knowledge. Vijnana means achara anushtanam, okay? Vijnana means achara anushtanam. Only when you do the achara anushtanam, you will realize this one is no different than what I said, vijnanam. So, previously I said, vijnana is wisdom. How the wisdom comes? Ekadesi vridam makes you very happy. It makes you, because I have done. I have seen that one. I have the experience. So, how it comes? Acharam anushtanam. So, knowledge with the acharam anushtanam, dharma sastra you follow, then you experience that knowledge, then you become the wise. That is what we said in the Uddhava Gita. Here, another definition we give. Yeah. Krishna is addressing Arjuna. Hey Arjuna, you want to know about me. I am telling you, you should think of me. Satyam, Jnanam, Anandam, Anandam, Amalatvam, Shriyapaditvam. 6 characteristics he is selling. So, very quickly, what is Satyam? Satya means no change at all. Constant in Swarupa, Sobhava, all of them. Absolute, unconditional existence. That is what Imbirmana's definition. Satyam means what? Sat means absolute, unconditional existence. Sat means na irukku. It's there. Sat. That means Bhagavan irukku. Sat. That is what it is. Asat. Enna da asat arka abdina? Mind lo unnu illa nartham. So, sat. Sat means irukku. Sri Bhashyatla solran. So, Satya means there is a Bhagavan, it's always there, unconditional, it doesn't change. So, Jnanam. Jnanam basically Swayam Prakasam. You don't need an external knowledge to show this one. It is telling by itself. That is basically Jnanam. Anantam. I am everywhere. I am at all the time. I exist in everything. I am everywhere. కాల దేశ వస్తు ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் இஸ் தேர் சர்வதேச சர்வகால சர்வாவஸ்தைகளிலும் நம்ம சொல்கிறோம் இல்லையா. ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் நவ் சத்தியம் ஞானம் அனந்தம் வி டாக் த்ரீ உபனிஷத் டஸ் ஒன்லி தோஸ் த்ரீ. இஃப் யூ டேக் தி ஆனந்தவல்லி தைத்திரோபனிஷத் ஓம் பிரம்ம விதாப்னோதி பரம் ததேஷாத்யுக்த சத்தியம் ஞானம் அனந்தம் பிரம்ம யோ வேத நிகிதம் குஹாயா. சத்தியம் ஞானம் அனந்தம் பிரம்ம, திஸ் இஸ் தி வேர்ட் யூ ஹேவ் டு மார்க் இட் டவுன். ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் அத்வைதி மத்வாச்சாரியா விசிஷ்ட அத்வைதம் எவ்ரிபடி டேக்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் தேர். பிரம்மம் இஸ் சத்தியம் ஞானம் அனந்தம். விசிஷ்ட அத்வைதம் வென் இட் கம்ஸ் டு எம்பெருமானார் இன் ஸ்ரீபாஷ்யம் ஈ ஆட்ஸ் த்ரீ மோர் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிஸ். ஈ ஆட்ஸ் ஆனந்தம். ஆனந்தம் மீன்ஸ் பிளிஸ், blissful in character. Anandam very equivalent, very simple. Embarumana says favorable. Favorable means anandam. See, avanalu thondaru illa avanal namak use da appadina odane anandam thondaru panuva. See, the enjoyment starts at the bottom. So anala favorable is that's what we call anukoolama irukana, that is anandam. Amalan means no flaws, okay. And shriyapadi, shriyapadi means say Sri Mahalakshmi is the husband for Sri Mahalakshmi. And he says, you cannot just take a Taittiriya Anandavalli and try to evaluate based on that one Brahmam. You have to take it from everywhere. He says, Shrishchade Lakshmisya Patnyau Ahoradre Parshve, another Upanishad says. So there also says, this Narayanan is the husband of Lakshmi. When he says like that one, that is also a unique property. So anala, Satyam, ஞானம், அனந்தம், ஆனந்தம், அமரத்துவம், ஸ்ரீயப்பதித்துவம். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் தி சிக்ஸ் ஒன். ஹே விஜயா, அர்ஜுனா, ஐ ஜஸ்ட் டோல்டு சத்தியம் எக்ஸெட்ரா சிக்ஸ் குவாலிட்டிஸ், தட் இஸ் கால்ட் ஸ்வரூப நிரூபக தர்மம். சேம் திங் வி ஸ்டடீட் இன் ஸ்ரீபாஷ்யம், கீதாபாஷ்யம், தத்துவத்ரய சிந்தனாதிகாரம் இன் எஸ்ஆர்டிஎஸ் ரகசத்ரசாரம் அண்ட் ஹியர் பகவத்கீதை. ஓகே, ஸோ அசாதாரண தர்மம், தர்மம் மீன்ஸ் குவாலிட்டி ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி. ஓகே, ஒரு பொருளுக்கு என்ன தர்மம்னா அதனுடைய குவாலிட்டி இஸ் கால் ஒரு சப்ஸ்டன்ஸ் இஸ் தே ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி. ஸோ சுரூப நிரூபக தர்மம் மீன்ஸ் ஐ கால் ரோட் இன் தி வாட்ஸ்அப் டுடே டிஸ்டிங்விஷிங் கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக்ஸ் மேக் இட் டிசி. ஸோ இட்ஸ் எ டிசி கரண்ட். ஓகே, டிஸ்டிங்விஷிங் அசாதாரணம். ரிமெம்பர் வித்தவுட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் தீஸ் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி யூ வில் நாட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தி ஆப்ஜெக்ட். Let us say you want to know something about an object. So can you describe an object? He was asking. So you try to explain that one. Without those, you will not understand the object. That is called Swarubhaga Nirubhaga Dharmam. Once you understand the item, then you know other things. This is what... You tell all other kinds of things. Once you know about that one, that is called Nirubhida Swarubha Visheshanam. That is called adjunct characters, AC. First one is a DC, this one is a AC. Adjunct means a thing added to something else already, supplementing rather than essential. Okay, let me tell you. Swarubha Nirubhaga Dharmam is basically Satyam, Jnanam, Anandam, Anandam, Amalatvam, Shepadithvam. Then you come here, Sausilyam, Vatsalyam, Daya, all those things are secondary properties. That is DC, this is AC. Let me give us another simple example. This is all from Gita Bhashyam. He is saying, in that one, somebody is asking how the elephant will look like. And you say, elephant is dark and it is large. Oh, then you go to a buffalo. Indian buffalo is also like that. So you cannot say that one. That will not uniquely identify that one. It is large and black. So you have to say ears are large. It's got a tongue. It's got a tusk and everything. When you say that, that uniquely identifies that one. So when you say president of the country, uniquely identify one person. Secretary, Abhina. There are 12 secretaries under him. Anybody. You understand? So, anala. DC is directly distinguished character. AC is adjunct, added characters and everything. So, when you come into that one, very easily you understand ACDC from Ragasetrasaram. In the Ragasetrasaram we say, Dharmi, substance is there. And how do you understand Atma? Because Atma knows me, I am a slave to Bhagavan. That is the Dharmi Jnanam. That is the DC. Unudiya Surubam. Then the DBJ, the Dharma Buddha Jnanam, what you acquired when you take the body, that is attributive knowledge, that is what basically AC property, Swabhavam. Surubam equals to DC, Swabhavam equals to AC. Swarubam equal to Swaruba Nirubhaga Dharmam. And Swabhavam is basically Nirubhida Swaruba Midhakukudena associated properties and everything. That is what we saw that. So easily remember Swarubam, Swabhavam. Swarubam is DC, Swabhavam is AC. Hey Arjuna, qualities like Satyam and everything, understand, you understand my Swarubam. And that is, you have to do the Ubhasyam as a Vilakshanam. I am different from all of them. Because he is the only one as giving Satyam, Jnanam, Anandam, Anandam, Amalatvam. He is the only one. Nobody else. One of them is good enough. But we like him, that's why we say all of them. Six properties are there. So, he is the president, he is the CEO, he is the chairman of the board. Idan onnu sonnale porum of all the three, the same person in a company. But we tell because he has got all the three. Now Krishna says, Bhakti Yoga when you do, everybody has to think of DC. Swarupa Nirubhaga Dharmam is a must for everybody. There are 31 Brahma Vidyas are there, which in the Bhakti Yoga, one is the Nyasa Vidya, remove that one. In the 31 Brahma Vidya, all of them, you should do DC. Swarupa Nirubhaga Dharmam. Satyam Jnanam Anandam. How can we capture that one? There's no way. That is why it is Bhakti Yoga is very difficult. So, and then added to that one, my other gunas are there. So many millions of Asangeya, Kalyana, Gunagana. And you choose dependent on which of the 31 Brahma Vidya you're going to follow. You understand? Yallarkum Swarupa Nirubhaga Dharmam, Satyam Jnana Manandam. That is why Upanishad says that. And then secondary properties depends on Brahma Vidya 1, Brahma Vidya 2, Brahma Vidya 4, Madhya Vidya, Tagara Vidya, all those you have to use certain kind of thing. Bhuma Vidya, all these things Arjuna, concentrate and understand. Then Arjuna is asking, Krishna, I don't understand. So many pralayams has happened, so many janmas happened. Is it so difficult to understand you? You explained this one. There should be some people should have understood you. Why it is so difficult to understand you? Then Krishna replied next to slogan. Manushyanam sagasreshu kaschid yadadi siddhaye yadadamabhi siddhanam kaschid mambeti tatvadaha. I tell you, of all the species I created, humans are very fraction. Humans are so small. Only humans can think and do this Bhakti Yoga. Animals cannot do that one. They can complete. You have to start only here. And you have to start only in a Brahmana Sariram. Because you have to start with Vedas. So we saw all these things. So out of that, these humans are so small. Among those humans, here we say Siddhi. Krishna uses Siddhi. Manushyanam sagasreshu kaschit yadadi siddhaye. Siddhi means perfection. Bhakti Yogatla perfection, out of all these people, very, very few people finish. Even tapas panna kuda, they are not working on Bhakti Yogam to go to the Bhagavan and go to the Moksham. When they are making an attempt to understand, to get something, vritham inda kadaikam apdina, inda vritham 48 days irukum. How many people finish 48 days? Some of them 10, they go away, 12, they go away. Even though the rewards, worldly rewards are there, they cannot. That's what Krishna first says. Siddhi, first perfection, nobody gets that one. Amongst the human, only a few strive for the perfection. Among the thousands of the perfected souls, those who did, 40 days I had done, and this was Yagadesi for them, 1 year I had done. These, they did for themselves. Worldly palan. They never thought of me, and for me they did that one. Look at that. Even people who do bhakti, this is where ordinary bhakti everybody does, and bhakti yogam will be different. Everybody does bhakti, but that is not bhakti yogam. So that's what you want. Even among those, realize me, they, many people do bhakti to get worldly things. Among them, one amount of a crore, one amount of a kodi, he does the bhakti towards me. Among those, one out of crore, they understand, I am the Upayam, I am the Phalam. Krishna very beautifully says, this is the first line in your prabhati. What do you do in the first line in the prabhati? Bhagavan is the means, Bhagavan is the ends. What Krishna told in Bhakti Yogam all the way at the end, that is where the starting point for you. What he told about six chapters and starting Bhakti Yogam, that is the first slogan in the Uddhava Gita. So prabhati, as I give an example, you go and join the Dharma Darsanam line there in Tirupati, you go and join next to this Dvajastambam. Those people come all the way, you go and join over there. That is how we join over here. So, as Krishna explained, Swarupa Nirubhaga Dharmam, Nirubhida Swarupa Visheshanam, that is DC and AC. And if you really look at that one, today I wrote, if you take the DC and AC current, what AC gives, for the same thing, more DC is needed, if you want to get a shock, okay? So why, for you to get AC is similar to Daya. Bhagavan konjam karuna kamchale odane apunjipodu. How do you understand Bhagavan Satyatvam? No way. He has to show more to get that shock. And how do you understand his jnanam? No way. But Perumal Devatsalyam, Perumaludaya, all this. So the AC is very easy for us. That is why our Alvar said, basically go with the AC, not with the DC. DC is very difficult. And this AC, when you take Perumaludaya, Saundaryam, Lavanyam and everything, we go through the Divya Mangala Vigraha easily. That is how we attached. Oh, if Bhagavan is like that, oh, I cannot even think of what he says to Swarupa Nirubhaga Dharma. It has to be really great. Only Jnani does. Let me do the prabhati. So very beautifully both. See, the reason why I'm giving all this from different places, you can, the school you study, all the subjects together. You study geography, you study history, you study English, you study computer science, you study psychology, sociology, everything. But when you go to the work, oh, you study the psychology, you do one day. Don't say that. They give a computer program. You see English, you see math in that, and you have to work with somebody, sociology, psychology, everything has to work on that. That is what we are. So we have to take from different places and connect all of them. All of them helps you to understand, to be a good Prabhanan. So whether it's a Sri Bhashyam, or Bhagavad Gita, or Uddhava Gita, or Vishnu Sahasranamam, or whether you do Tika, or any writing, all of them. How do I do? One is not independent. We cannot do the Sri Bhashyam and complete. You have to do on the way simultaneously. You cannot do all of the geography and then next one you go to English. You cannot do. So as we go along, it's like a spiral staircase. So that is the approach we are doing over here. Kavidharkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashalini Simade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Simade Nigamanta Maha Deshigaya Namaha.